All right, so feeling a bit better. I figured, let's see what's going on. All right, let's see what's going on. Let's see what's going on. Yeah, let's see what's going on. All right, so first things first, praise the Most High for having us here. And then, let's get started. All right, let's see what is influencing the read. Looks, are we investing? We're ready to invest in this union, in this situation, this bit of stability and security, trying to create some sort of, I don't know what it is exactly, but it looks very secure, looks very happy, looks very much like a dynasty, something, a bit of a legacy. Oh, is that a reverse that slipped out? Ten of Cups, wow. Oof, are we fearful of this? All right, we're actually in a position where not only is this our Ten of Cups, but it's also on the table as a Ten of Pentacles, generational wealth, success, the legacy that we've always wanted to create. But why the fear? What's going on? What? Marriage, union, stability, security on both sides, equal, everything balanced, fair and just. It sounds good to me. It sounds wonderful. Let's keep going. Let's see what's good. What's going on in the ethers? We got a wounded warrior. You've been through the ringer, buddy. So maybe it's too good to be true. Right? Maybe some familiar territory. Been hurt a bit of times. Coming out of a painful cycle with the Queen of Wands. What is this? All right, so hold on. This is different. Let's check on this. Seven of Swords, the Moon, and the Judgment. So it looks like somebody's being strategic about their placements of what they're doing. Looks like they're leaving some important information out of a situation. They're hiding something. Okay. So, this was a close of a cycle that was rather painful, but all the pain has been released. It's completely dissipated. We don't have to worry about the Ten Swords at all. Like, it's almost as they're like, yeah, it was, whatever. We're good. So, like, they're not worried about it. I'm not worried about it. We're cooling over that. But, let's get some more on that. What's this about? Oh, blast from the past. Somebody you left out in the cold wants to come around. All right, so as I said, we're not worried about this because you've healed from this. And because you've healed from this, you're truly able to move forward, create something beautiful, right? Now, it looks like while you're going through all of this and your fears getting the best of you, while you're investing in something that's very much magnificent and swell and stupendous. I don't know any more S words, but I was just going to keep going, you feel me? But, yeah, I was trying to keep going. I'm sorry, but somebody else is, you know, spying, lurking, watching, seeing what's going on. They're playing around in your energy. I want to say they're honestly attempting to pick with you. They're in a lower vibration, as you can see. They want to return. They're having some nostalgia, my friends. All right, so must we? So it looks like this knight would like to heal the situation. Alright. Three of Swords, bottom of the deck. They want to come around and heal the situation. Maybe they're seeing this particular wounded warrior as wish fulfillment. Or let's get another deck. How about that? How about that? Let's get another deck. How about... sounds good. Let's go. Sounds good. Alright, we're gonna see what this bad boy is about, okay? We're gonna see what this bad boy is about right here. The Star, Knight of Wands, Two of Pentacles. Je ne sais. One more time. Two, So we got Six of Pentacles, reciprocity, fair exchange. All right, so let's see what the Star, Knight of Wands, Two of Pentacles combination is all about. Page of Swords, this spying energy. Okay. Bottom of the deck, Four of Pentacles. Let's see what we got. Boom. Four of Cups. Eight of Cups. The Lovers. Queen of Wands. Ace of Swords. So ever since you walked away and really rejected them and left them out in the cold, they're really feeling it. I'm not going to say that they're feeling it, but it may be that they're feeling a particular Queen of Wands in your energy. Somebody who has your attention. Saying, buddy. Let's clarify that Queen of Wands. Queen of Wands. Queen of Wands. Oh, I'm sorry. This Queen of Wands is this returning energy. Interesting. So, let's see this one more time. Spying, watching, feeling rejected, meditating her on her feelings as you walked away. So then I wonder, now she's disappointed, wants to come in with an offer to give to the King of Wands. So at one point you guys were matching. So what's being seen clearly? I'm missing that part. Hold on, let's see what's going on there, because I'm missing a piece. I'm missing something. We're missing some. Let's get into it. Let's see what's good with this Lovers. King of Cups. That's what it is. There's feelings invested. But you've healed from the situation. She's not just a Queen of Wands. She's also a King of Cups. Mostly expressive. And she's... If she's a King of Cups in the reverse. Because you know, I just picked up the deck. But if this King of Cups were potentially in the reverse, could be... love bombing, gaslighting, you know, not secure in his emotions, all over the place, wishy-washy, rather turbulent. So what's being seen clearly with the Ace of Swords? Ace of Swords, what's being seen clearly? The investment, the fact that they want to invest and have this leap of faith, have this new beginning with this energy, right? Boom, Page of Cups. Okay, so my question is, we see what's going on. We see what they want. That's cute, right? That's nice, buddy. Okay, so let's see what's going on with you, right? All right, let's let your energy do the talking. All right, we gotta do no he say she say. We could just, you know, gotta fix cars. Gotta buy some time. Feel me? But, you know, we're going to get into this. We're going to figure this out, all right? She wants to come around, heal, fix, and talk about whatever this situation may be. Cool beans, right? That's nice. Now, seeing the situation as wish fulfillment. Okay. I got a quick question. Nine of Wands, Okay, so yes, so we're cool. Okay, we're cool. Ah, ha, ha, the Divine Feminine. Very good. Okay, so the Wounded Warrior is, in fact, the Divine Feminine. Very good. So what we're going to do for this next portion, what we're going to do is we're going to find out what this... We'll take it from the bottom of the deck. Boom. What this Divine Feminine is actually up to. Because as we've seen with the Ten of Swords reversed, she's really released this situation. She's really released this energy, the hurt, the pain, everything that had anything to do with it. So we want to see what's really good. Because we do see that she's dealing with some rather traumatic energy. Alright, she's in a real traumatized headspace, I want to say. Not as bad as the Nine of Swords, but you do see the bandage on the head. He's using the wand to hold himself up there. Alright, and definitely see the strength in reverse. The only time that you need strength is when what's involved. fear, right? So we're facing some fears, we're looking some things in the eye, and I feel like she may not be feeling her strongest in these particular situations, but possibly because of these past situations over here. Nonetheless, we're gonna see, we're gonna let her energy do the talking instead of me just assuming, making an ass of, you know, me. So let's go, turn up, let's go. All right, so okay, Eight of Wands, movement, communication, dialogue, messages, travel. All right, so let's see what's going on with this Empress and the Ten. What's going on with the Empress? What is going on with this Empress? Okay. She's taking a leap of faith. The wounded warrior's taking a leap of faith. She's putting in some work, it seems, at that table. Yes, she is. Okay, let's go. Passion and new beginning, I see. With the Ace of Wands. Okay. Okay. Looks like she's definitely taking some time to rest at this particular time. Okay. Looks like she's working on her heart chakra. She's literally laying in the bed with her heart. Looks like the core to her heart is wrapped around the I don't know what that would be, but it's like the twigs in the bed and the nest that make the nest. Okay, but she's definitely taking time to rest. Nine of Cups. This is another energy over here. The Wheel of Fortune. Very good. Who is the Nine of Cups? Queen of Wands. Dun, dun, dun. So, okay, in actuality, what's going on is she is taking a new leap of faith, and she's very much happy and free. She's closed that cycle successfully, and as we said before, this other energy did feel it. And with that, they had a bit of a shakeup. With that shakeup, I guess they attempted to come in and make amends in some way. Nonetheless, it wasn't going down that way, and that situation came to a halt. They had a tower moment, and you see where that goes. So it looks like this particular divine masculine is in his King of Swords, Queen of Swords. All right, so it looks like he's healing his divine feminine energy, transforming himself. All right, and it looks like he's actually hopping into his divine feminine energy to heal, to rest and to heal. It looks like he is chatty. He is, you know, having conversations, discerning the situation. Swords down, so he's not feeling defensive or combative, but he's just kind of like, you know, there, you know, watching what comes his way. Okay, divine masculine, divine feminine. I like the way this energy has both energies balanced. Very good. So okay, King of Cups. Six of Wands. I think somebody's captured this Emperor's heart, bro. What's up with this King of Cups? Page of Wands, Eight of Swords. The announcement that's leaving somebody stuck. The announcement that somebody's waiting to hear. Looks like this is hidden information with the Moon. Yeah, so it looks like the Queen of Swords has surrendered this energy. She could possibly be birthing her new beginning. She's gained a perspective and she knows where she's going. She's ready to go. She was regretful. Okay. again, hasn't disclosed who, what, or where she's going. But there's somebody who's captured her heart. Who's this King of Cups? Who's this King of Cups? Oh, no. This King of Cups is this guy. Ouch. So I want to know who's on this new passionate beginning. We're going to need another deck. Oh, wait, no. Damn it. I'm so sorry, guys. Please judge me not. King of Cups is upset that there's going to be a new beginning with another dude. Okay, I need another deck. That's my problem. I need another deck. I want to see who the frick the person is. See, because of this person who's captured her heart, there's a blockage to having this new beginning because somebody else is in the mix for them. But we need a deck. We need a deck. Old TikTok. Come on, let's go. All right. Okay, so. Whoa. Okay. Let's just close that right there. Who's on this new beginning? Queen of Cups. Exactly. I knew somebody's captured her heart. So the Nine of Pentacles we just seen over here is apparently the energy who's captured this Queen of Cups heart. Okay. Very good. Okay. Who is this? Okay. Who captured this? Okay. It's a Two of Cups. Okay. Somebody who's balanced and fair, equally yoked. Again, this energy hasn't been disclosed out in the open just yet. Moving forward in balanced energies, only the Emperor and Empress and the Chariot. Very good. There's going to be an announcement made. All right, Bomb, Knight of Wands. So it looks like this Queen of Cups is fleeing and moving towards this Two of Cups partnership rather quickly, too. I say so myself. Let's keep going. Ace of Pentacles. Okay. So, okay, so when it comes down to over here, all this wonderful, beautiful energy, okay, it's moving quickly, it's a new beginning, there's travel, there's plans, it's happy, it's healthy, it's vibrant, it's awesome, it's equally yoked, it's very much fair, reciprocity. But it leaves this energy over here in a bit of a state of confusion. All right, now, because they're receiving lack of communication with the High Priestess, they know that they've been released, but they're not sure what's going on this aspect because they're no longer receiving that attention. Okay, we got a Ten of Cups. So it looks like somebody's waiting for the opportunity to fight for this Ten of Cups situation. They see her in this situation as their potential Ten of Cups, when in actuality, this Empress is here working on her Ten of Pentacles. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Generational wealth, success, luxury. Of course you can have love in that. She's a Queen of Cups. That's naturally there. Come on now. Wonderful. Not to mention she's the Empress. Alright, let's go. So somebody's made a final decision, it looks like, with this judgment card here. Okay. Well, somebody's gaining perspective with the Two of Wands in the challenge position. So they're not 100% sure about what they're seeing. Somebody may... Oof. Oof. Okay. So... Okay. All right. We have an Emperor in reverse. Somebody who's a dictator. Somebody who's controlling. Somebody who's overbearing. Trying to gain perspective on the confusion that they're seeing, possibly with the blessing in their life. Oh, why is this on my table? What is this? Emperor in reverse, please. What is that? The Emperor in reverse. I don't even know if this was a deck I should have picked up. I don't even know how many cards are out here. Nine of Wands. Two of Swords. The Wheel of Fortune. So basically it's the same energy over here, upset and frantic about what's going on. So because they're losing control, they're beginning to act more like as a tyrant as opposed to a divine masculine or somebody taking accountability and leadership in the situation. What's going on with that? This was not the way we were supposed to wake up, guys. This is all over the place. I apologize. Tenosaur. But it's in the upright. So she's released the pain. Now, they're just now feeling it. Okay, now, as we also said, they're also now realizing and feeling the pull of energy. Not pull, she's pulling on them, but at one point she was giving energy to them. And as we said, there's a new soulmate who snuck up in here. She's actually willing to give that cup of love to this energy. Everybody knows the Queen of Cups is very reserved with that cup. It's not going to just any suitor. So that's a pretty big deal. So she's actually willing to give up her cup of love. This energy is no longer feeling that energy being thrown into that direction. It is now feeling the lack of being poured in another direction. Okay? So that's kind of leaving them in a kind of paranoid mental state. Leaving them to be a bit of an emperor in reverse. Okay? A bit defensive, standing their ground. Let's just see what this is. Seven of Wands. Two of Pentacles. Ten of Wands. Seven of Pentacles. So they want to invest in the situation, but this is a done deal. And I only say that because we've seen that she's moved forward. They're actually having anxiety and they're seeing things clearly about this entire situation, it seems. Let's go back to this. So they're having anxiety about the ending, the betrayal, how everything happened. Maybe they weren't seeing it clearly. Things were hidden for them at the time. But, yeah, now they're realizing what's actually going on. Ten of Pentacles on the table. We already seen what the Ten of Pentacles is. They realize that this feminine energy is investing in another avenue. So because this Queen of Cups is moving towards her wish fulfillment and investing in this Ten of Pentacles, she's putting five and somebody else is putting five, and they're going to create a very beautiful legacy that leaves somebody feeling left out, abandoned, and in the cold. Alright. Okay, we're going to leave that there. Alright, alright, yeah, we're going to leave that there. Yeah. Feel bad for this guy. He's kind of frantic. That's why he's acting this way. More of a tyrant than a leader. That's not cool. But if you step up, take accountability, at least you can have a friend in this situation. But it looks like this Queen of Cups has found a soulmate or a suitor in which she would like to give her cup to. Maybe she's moving things fast, a bit recklessly. But maybe she's just passionate about this journey that they're going to be on and ready to travel. We've already seen that there's Emperor and Empress energy. Okay, so, good stuff. All right, so we're going to leave this one right here. All right, 22:23 on the clock. All right, I thought I saw 22:22, but it changed too quickly. All right, so, see you guys later. As you can see, I'm getting tired again, so I'm going to go back to bed. Talk to you guys soon. Love and light.